I can throw a tube jig there. It's 9, 10, 11 feet of water. Maybe pop one on a tube. When there's two, three, four together, they'll race at it. Let's try it. Pick, I'll have this right here. My trusty topwater back and forth. My little 3.5-inch tube jig. Maybe they'll think it's a perch and just whack, slam it. Let it sink down in a small snap. And it's so important to be near these weeds. So important. I see the rock, and these fish are just coming in and out, in and out. The ones I see out there, yeah, I can pick up the drop shot. I could probably catch them. But I think those are the ones that are chilling out. They've eaten already. They're going to eat, but they're just chilling out. I want the ones that are aggressively feeding. And every once in a while, I come into these weeds. I have my track on, the chart. I got the sonar, traditional. I can see the weed. Sometimes I see the tops, and sometimes all I see on the sonar is just the tips of the weed, knowing that there's weed down there. This gives me that extra confidence to fish, knowing that these smallmouth are near the weed and rock, just like this here. Look at it. Weed, 6.7. It's all weed there, different things. And here's my track. So I go out wider, see where I've been, and make waypoints. That's 120 feet, 120 meters out. So when I'm real tight, I bring it in and see where I've been. So a combination of traditional sonar with a chart are helping me catch these smallmouth on Island Lake Camp. Oh, the surface plate there. Yep. Wow, eh? Just finished saying, huh? Just finished saying. Got near those weeds. And I felt that familiar. Boop. Oh, yeah. Isn't that nice? Oh, yeah. Just a chunky fish. Beautiful Ontario smallmouth. You can't beat that, man. Throw in the top waters, different baits, kiss and release, okay? Ready? Go on. Wow. Just snapping it. Yep. See, I got my hand. When I throw that tube jig, I know that it's like throwing a bucktail. I do it enough times. I know where the fish are. It's all about timing. Fish moving in to feed and stuff. And I just finished saying, I need one to be about 2 feet below the surface. I saw the weeds coming off that point, threw in, went down about that far, boom, right away.
Island Lake Camp, where reality meets paradise. As you leave Highway 64 and travel 3.5 miles to the end of the road, you'll begin a truly northern experience. When you arrive at Island Lake Camp, you will find 8 well-appointed pine-decorated cottages encircling a quiet bay on Thistle Lake. Secluded sandy beaches, waterfalls, and their own hidden bay will beckon you. Relax at the water's edge and view the glorious lake views from your screened-in porch. In the evenings, gather around the wood stove, enjoy a game of cards, watch TV, or just swap stories with other guests. Fishing at Island Lake Camp is excellent for walleye, smallmouth bass, and trophy-sized northern pike. As the only outfitter on the lake and no other boat access to this lake, this makes for great fishing for walleyes in the spring and fall near the two rivers flowing into the lake. All the lodge boats are equipped with 4-stroke electric start motors, fish finders, padded seats, and are fully serviced every day. Contact Gord Mitchell at Island Lake Camp to book your Northern Ontario adventure at this clean, comfortable, and truly wonderful outfitter located in Field, Ontario.
Something magical for me, getting up early, the anticipation, the butterflies of just going fishing. And that's what I did on this trip to Island Lake Camp. Just went fishing, caught some fish, saw a bunch more, but just had a fantastic adventure once again in Northern Ontario.